This place gave me my first real look at how the world worked. I watched people running toward the betting window with high hopes. No plan. Then I watch them walk away from the track, ripping up their tickets in disgust. That wasn't gonna be me.
You didn't bet?
No, I bet. I bet, but first I figured out where the sharp action was, where the guys who had a plan were. Guys who grinded, took the guesswork out of it. They knew which drivers had been rested, they knew which horses were ready. They also knew which ones were on last legs.
How'd you meet those guys?
I didn't at first. But I figured out that they always bet late and they bet heavy. So I started watching that instead of that. The numbers told the story, they always do. Well, I started making bets of my own, you know, the right ones. And once I understood what had happened, I watched the track to see how it happened.
You want to talk about a well-rested horse? Let's talk about this IBB trade. These biotechs have been going nuts these past few days, and I'll tell you something, I am not surprised at all. I've been harping on this 300 level for the biotechs. This is a daily chart. Look at this. Look how long it's been sitting here in this base, this super, super, super base. This is January 2016 where it first started. So here's a weekly chart down here, and you can just see how long this level has been in play. It seems like forever. It's been 15, 16 months since the beginning of 2016. 2014, 2015, these biotechs for the stocks to trade, they go absolutely nuts. So I've been waiting for this breakout forever. And we caught it. I did well with it. Up 42.59 today. I've been in it for the past 3 days, about 5,500 in the trade or so. Only risked like $600. I didn't get as much stock as I wanted to at all, but that's how it goes with the best ones. But let's talk about it. Oh, and to all you scammers out there, let's look at. So this is our newsletter from last week, coming at you June 19th, 2 days ago. All right, where we at? Okay, biotechs. Last week, I thought I had it right where I wanted. This week, buying off 292 for the break of the monster at 300 level. Day-to-day action, sloppy, but if this one is able to get out of the consolidation area, it's one you definitely want to be in. 300 remains at bye. So I've been waiting on this level for a while. So it shook me out last week. I had some stock. Let's go to a 15-minute on the bottom. So it shook me out last week. Zoom in close on the daily. I bought off this inside day right here. It gave me a nice move to 298, but then it shook me out. And that's what I was talking about at the end of the week last week. So I was focused on this name from the get-go, and I saw Monday we opened up, and I bought 100 shares, 295, just because I had to be in. I saw it upticking. I saw a decent looking volume, but I did not load the boat at all. I loaded the boat last week on tight risk. I got stopped out, took a small loss. So this week I bought 295 and I'm like, I see it beasting all day and I know about this huge level, but it's just up so much. It's up $8. I can't add this today. So what do? I wait till tomorrow. I wait till the next day. So here's the 15 minute. Here's this 295 buy. I bought 295 right here. I give it to a low of day, 293. It says 293.69. I'm giving it 293 in the biotechs. So I'm risking $200 on that trade. So then it beasts all day right at this 300 level. Now, we look at this 300 level. This level is huge. Huge. Every time it gets up there, it fails. Now, the longer a stock is in a consolidation period, the bigger the breakout you can expect. And that's why I'm not surprised at all to have these biotechs going nuts. So I only had 100 shares approaching this level on this day. I bought $295, $200 risk. I'm up nice in it, but if it's going to break out, I'm like, fuck, I need more stock. And $200 doesn't satisfy my appetite. So, and it just flags at the end of all day. I was looking for any pullback. Here's a 15-minute. It just went sideways and higher all day. So now, here is, and I called this out in chat, this day. And, you know, today is making this day. It looked like nothing, but look at this volume yesterday. So I called it out yesterday. I said tight risk ad in the chat. I bought 300 and I gave it to the low of this little mini 15-minute flag yesterday. Bought 300 shares at 300 and gave it a dollar, $2.99. So I'm risking $300 on that stock. And I risked $200 on the entry. So I risked $500 on the trade. You can see what I'm up. I only had 400 shares, but I traded it really well. So then yesterday, and this is why I was talking about sticking to the game plan in the premise video. So yesterday, I mean, it's beasting. Everyone's talking about the biotech. Look at this. The high of yesterday is 308. So my average price is probably around 299 now. It's up 308. It's up $9. And everyone's talking biotech. The market's so weak otherwise. And it comes back at the end of the day. Look at this. And then it's not looking at today. At highs of yesterday, 308. And it closes the day, 303. Drops $5 and 400 shares. It's $2,000 pullback from it. Everyone's in there like, oh, biotech's. What are you doing with your stock? I said, I'm just sticking to the game plan, okay? As long as it's above 300, it's still healthy, and it hasn't been above this level in a long, long time. So what did I do? I held on to my stock. I stuck to the game plan, and look at what it paid off today. So how did I trade it today? Boom. You see this little red slash right here? That was me taking my first 100 shares off, 309. That's the one I bought at 295, $2 risk, 14 points, 7-1 risk reward. Not so bad for your first kick. So then later on in the day, where'd I sell? Oh, man, making myself look like a bitch now. So you see this red slash over here? This is 314. It made a high, touched 314, pulled back a little. I sold another 100 shares. 314, I bought at 300. I was risking $1. That's 14-1 right there. That's not so bad. So now I'm still holding 200 shares because if we go to a weekly chart, this thing is a monster. Ooh, look at those nice little red dashes. But look at this volume breaking out of this huge consolidation. So this is stock I want to hold. This is a well-rested horse coming out of a stable. These are the ones you want to be in. These are the ones you want to focus on. If I could take one trade a year, it'd be these huge stocks coming out of bases. Okay? Let's, you know, we saw it. Oh, what the fuck are you doing? We saw it in Wynn earlier in the year. Huge base. We saw it in Chipotle earlier in the year. Huge base. We saw it in Regeneron earlier in the year. Huge base, huge breakout. So now a sector like biotechs, a fucking crazy high beta sector that when you get them right, you get them so, so right. I risked $500 on this trade, and I'm up 5,800. I'm up over 10-1. I was up 4,200 today. I had to take some profit. So I got these 200 shares, and I'm just trailing them now. I'm going to let it see what it can do. All right? So I just wanted to show you guys the thoughts and the reasoning behind that trade. Big bases. What do you want is big, big bases. Weekly chart trades. As always, let's look at a 30-minute. We look at 30-minute entries that can affect a stock's daily and weekly chart. That's how we trade. That's how we get these huge risk-reward scenarios. And math, that's the name of the game. I'm up over 10-1 on this trade. Risk $500, 5,800. That's good math. Always have math on your side, all right? So that's all I got for you guys in this one, all right? Good luck. Happy trading.